The Lakers season is here. LeBron James heading into his 22nd NBA campaign, and apparently it will not be his last, with new reporting from Shams Charania. I'm Trevor Lane. This is the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Subscribe right there. Make sure you stay up to date on all things Lakers. All right, here's Shams Charania on the Pat McAfee Show today, talking about LeBron's future in LA and in the NBA. This is certainly noteworthy.
LeBron, and how long does this last? How long does this last? This guy is unbelievable.
Can we rewind the tapes? I said on this show, I want to say when the season ended, 2 years at least, you know, could he go three potentially? But when you think about 2 years, that's this season and next season. And next season, like, great timing, right? It is All-Star game, All-Star weekend in Los Angeles. And that would be year 23 for number 23. It is a lot of good parallels for next season. But listen, if LeBron James wants to play a third season and wants to play beyond next season, I don't think anyone would be surprised. But obviously, whenever he does retire, I think he deserves kind of that farewell moment that Vince Carter got, that Kobe Bryant got, that the different players have received. And so I do think we'll know if it is the last year, because it's something that you'll want to celebrate, one of the greats of the game, like we have with Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, and now potentially LeBron James. So I think next year is the window, really, for when you think about last season, and then obviously the year after that, if he can. But I don't think there's any like minutes restriction on LeBron James. You always have to be mindful of a guy that's going to turn 40 years old in December. But I think going into the year, we saw him at the Olympics, how great he looked at the Olympics. Him and Anthony Davis, two of the top six, seven-ish players on that Olympic team. And now the Lakers have those two guys. And I think the way he looked then, the way he looked in preseason, I don't think there's anyone that's going to be holding LeBron back, unless it's, you know, it's you know, he's going to be entering year 22. Like, God, there's eventually going to be a period.
Got to ask if Steve Kerr wouldn't play anybody else.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
That's everybody's.
All right. So the only thing that I'll disagree with there with Shams is saying that AD and LeBron were two of the top six or seven. LeBron won MVP. He was the best player on the Olympic team. You might want to make an argument for Steph Curry. You'd be wrong. LeBron James was the best player on the Olympic team. And Anthony Davis, I think, was certainly in the mix as well. If I were to order it, it would be, and call me biased, I certainly am, but LeBron, Steph, then Anthony Davis. He was phenomenal. He was their best big. He beat out Joel Embiid. But that's kind of beside the point. The main thing is that LeBron James, according to Shams, is going to play 2-3 more years. Wow. We didn't know exactly when LeBron was going to retire, what that's going to look like. Shams does make a good point that he's probably going to want that retirement tour of sorts that we saw Kobe get. And so it will be announced. We will know. It's not like we're going to get to the end of this season and LeBron just goes, oh, see you later, I'm out. No, he's going to let you know ahead of his final season that that's going to be it. And get the fanfare and everything that goes along with that. So Shams saying, no, it's not going to be this is not his last season. He's going to play at least two more seasons, maybe three. So here's what that looks like for the Lakers. If he plays, let's say he plays two more seasons, he has a player option for next year at $52.6 million. He probably just picks that up. Now, technically, he could just sign a new contract, do a new deal similar to the one that he just signed, and then he would have a third year on the books for the Lakers. Then maybe he plays the third season. We'll see. But right now, that player option for next year. So he plays this season for the Lakers, age 40, turning 40 in December, then plays the next season as well. You look at Anthony Davis's contract. His deal has a player option at the end of it for the 2027-2028 season. If we're looking at a post-LeBron era in which Anthony Davis is leading the Lakers, it would be if LeBron plays, let's say it's two more seasons, we'd be talking about a 33-year-old Anthony Davis. And that's where, from a team perspective, from a planning perspective, when the Lakers are out there on the trade market and they're looking for players, this is why Rob Pelinka is saying, if we're going to give up both of our future firsts, we have to have a player that's going to bring sustained Lakers excellence. In other words, we need to have somebody that's going to help us win right now, plus into the future, be that guy alongside Anthony Davis, who again could be 33 years old by the time LeBron James decides to walk away, or even older if LeBron plays for 3 years. Now, this is, of course, assuming that LeBron will continue playing for the Lakers and he won't jump ship and join some other club. Right now, player option for next year, in theory, he could opt out of his player option, become a free agent next summer, and walk away. I don't think that's to another team. I don't think that's likely. I think he probably winds up staying with the Lakers for the remainder of his career, and certainly the Lakers would like to help facilitate that. But from a team planning perspective, if you have two more years of LeBron, I think that only increases the amount of focus that you have to have on whoever that guy is that you get. If you're going to give up what remaining tradable future draft capital you have, it needs to be somebody that's going to fit long-term next to Anthony Davis, in addition to fitting right now with the team currently as is. So that's going to be a big question for the Lakers on the trade market. But LeBron, good to know that he's not hanging him up anytime soon, particularly now that his son, Bronny, has joined the Lakers. Speaking of which, Shams Charania also talked a bit about that. Bronny and LeBron on the court together, and how the Lakers are going to try to pull that off tonight and whether it might be situational. Here's what he had to say.
Heard Wendy, that's Brian Windhorst. I don't know if you've met him yet, but once you do, you get in his hip pocket. You're going to learn a lot from that man at ESPN. He said that if the game is going good tonight, you're going to want to be in your seat the start of the second quarter because you might see Bronny.
What?
Have you been heard? Is that potentially, is Bronny going to get a lot of playing tonight? We want to see Big Brown and Little Brown play tonight.
Yeah, I was on the 4:10 a.m. Pacific Time Sports Center, and I said it is very likely LeBron James and Bronny James.
Get off of 4:10 a.m.
Ingrained in my mind, 4:10 a.m. I was dreading 4:10 a.m. is something early. on the West
Coast. We got to get back to the negotiating table, brother.
Welcome to the jungle.
No, we're here for it. It's opening night, baby.
You're right. It's all day celebration. Yeah,
we're ready for it.
All right, sorry.
It's a celebration of the NBA returning.
Let's go back to 4:10 a.m.
What I said was, it is very likely that both of them play tonight, and we see history tonight. Never have we seen in the NBA a father and son duo play in an NBA game at the same time, and it is very likely, as long as the game is competitive and it's within the flow of the game. Like, listen, if the Lakers are down 15 and it's 6 minutes into the first quarter, I don't know if tonight is going to be the night. But if it is a game, if it is a close game, if it is a flow of competition, I think there is an expectation. I think there is a plan to have this moment, celebrate this moment. We probably will never see this ever again in the NBA. Like, LeBron James in year 22 has spoke this into existence in a lot of ways. So I think a celebration of history is what we're going to see. And then from there, it's going to be about how Bronny James develops. And come November, he's going to be spending time in the G League. And LeBron James is going to keep having to lead this team along with Anthony Davis like he's born to do.
Let's see what Bronny does tonight. Okay, because when Bronny's playing above the rim tonight, with his dad, and all of a sudden his jumper is just silky.
Wet.
Which could happen. Yeah. Big lights, big time.
It could happen in the first quarter. Could happen in the second quarter. I do think it's going to be early, though. Like, it's not – I don't think they're going to wait for the second half. I don't think they're going to wait for late in the first half. I think if it's a close game, I would not be surprised, you know, mid to late first quarter, second quarter, have this moment.
All right, so that's interesting in terms
of
strategy.
And how long does this last?
From the Lakers, that Bronny playing is very much a situational thing. That it depends on how the game is going. And I think that's absolutely the right way. For me, you know, from a Lakers perspective, obviously from a parental perspective, from the perspective of a parent, it's amazing that LeBron is going to play in an NBA game with Bronny. I mean, who would have ever thought that this would happen? That a father and son would play not only in the NBA at the same time, but on the same team. That's absolutely unbelievable that something like that is happening, and it's going to be an incredible moment. But I do like that Shams is clarifying that, hey, it's probably going to be like late first quarter, early second quarter. This is not crunch time. We're going to throw Bronny in or something like that. And it also depends on how the game is going. If the game's not going well and the Lakers need to make up ground and there's no margin for error, you're not going to put Bronny in. He's primarily going to spend the bulk of the season in the G League. He's going to be in the G League, nothing wrong with that. We've talked about it, but he's going to spend the bulk of the season developing in the G League on the South Bay Lakers. Fantastic. Develop there, no problem. He's not ready to step onto an NBA court in a competitive game right now. You want to put him in garbage time minutes, something like that? Sure, he can get experience that way, but ready to go into a competitive game, let alone against the Minnesota Timberwolves. No, he's not ready for that, nor should the expectation be that he's ready for that. So for the Lakers, if you're going to make this moment happen in tonight's game, it can't be in a situation where your margin for error is gone. And you have to put him in where he has a opportunity to succeed. And that means most likely when the Wolves have their bench in. That's when you're going to put in Bronny and hopefully surround him, not just with LeBron, but with some other starting caliber players so that he is insulated to a degree. And then you play 2-3 minutes, something like that. You get your moment, and then you go on and you do what you can to go win the game. And if you're down and you're trying to play catch up, if you're down 10 points at the end of the first quarter, then maybe you say, you know what? Tonight's not the night. Tonight's not the night. We'll try again next game. And you go from there. Because if you're the Lakers in the Western Conference, as amazing as this moment is, the West, there is no margin for error. It's unforgiving. Every single game matters. In March, in April, we're going to be looking back on the games right now in October, in November, saying, man, I wish they had won that game, or if they hadn't dropped that game, we'd be in much better shape. These games matter a ton. Every game matters in the Western Conference, so you can't mess around. Hopefully, the Lakers find themselves in a position to put Bronny in tonight. You get that incredible moment, but if that's not in the cards, if the game script does not allow that, then I like the Shams of saying, hey, you know, it may not wind up being tonight. But I do think the Lakers are going to do everything they can to make it happen tonight. And hopefully, the Lakers, fingers crossed, are in a good spot at, say, the beginning of the second quarter. They can put in Bronny, and we do get that amazing moment. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. What do you think about LeBron playing for two, maybe three more NBA seasons? What does that mean for the Los Angeles Lakers? And your thoughts on Bron and Bronny playing together on the floor tonight. Again, don't forget to subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Till next time, see you, and stay safe.